Let us all rejoice in the Lord, for our Savior has been born in the world. Today, true peace has come down to us from heaven. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the Lord be with you. On this glorious night, we have a Savior who is born to us. So we come and with hearts rejoicing and in celebration, we call to mind our sins and praise God for his mercy. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who have made this most sacred night radiant with the splendor of the true light, grant, we pray, that we who have known the mysteries of his light on earth may also delight in his gladness in heaven, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
The first reading is a reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Upon those who dwelt in the land of gloom, a light has shone. You brought them abundant joy and great rejoicing, as they rejoice before you as the harvest, as people make merry when dividing spoils, for the yoke that burdened them, the pole on their shoulder, and the rod of their taskmaker you smashed as on the day of Midian. For every boot that tramped in battle, every clog that rolled in blood, will be burned as fuel for flames. As a child is born to us, a son is given. Upon his shoulder, dominion rests. As they name him Wonder Counselor, God Hero, Father Forever, Prince of Peace, his dominion is vast and forever peaceful. From David's throne and over his kingdom, which he confirms and sustains, by judgment and justice, both now and forever, the zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
The second reading is a reading from the letter of St. Paul to Tinnitus. Beloved, the grace of God has appeared, saving all, and training us to reject godless ways and worldly desires, and to live temporarily, justly, and devoutly in this age, as we wait the blessed hope, the appearance of glory of our great God and Savior, Jesus Christ, who gave himself for us to deliver us from all the unlawfulness and to cleanse for himself a people of his own, inert to do what is good. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. In those days, a decree went forth from Caesar Augustus that the whole world should be enrolled. This was the first enrollment. When Cornelius was governor of Syria, so all went to be enrolled, each in their own town. And Joseph too went up from Galilee, from the town of Nazareth, to Judea, to the city of David, that is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and family of David, to be enrolled with Mary, his betrothed, who was with child. While they were there, the time came for her to have her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son. She wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. Now there were shepherds in the region, living in the fields and keeping the night watch over their flocks. The angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were struck with great fear. The angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for behold, I proclaim to you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. For today in the city of David, a Savior was born for you, who is God the Lord and Lord. And this will be a sign for you. You will find an infant wrapped in swaddling clothes, laying in a manger." And suddenly there was a great multitude of heavenly hosts with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to those on whom his favor rests." The Gospel of the Lord.
Each of us have been at a certain point in our life, we have a memory, or maybe two or many, of a time where we were frustrated far beyond what our capacity really was at the time. Perhaps it was something that just happened to occur and made us maybe say a few words that we we would have otherwise not have wanted to say. And something that we look back on now, and perhaps it's even one of our stories that we share with our friends and loved ones, that we can now look back on with a little bit of humor about how silly the whole thing was. But in that moment, it seemed like such an important thing. It seemed like the most important thing, that nothing else that was going on right then mattered. But of course, it's maybe some of the small things in life, but we also have those big things that we encounter as well. At a certain point in our life, perhaps it's near the end of our life, where we are wondering, now that I don't work, now that most of my friends and family have gone before me in the sleep of peace of Christ, now that I don't have the things that I used to do anymore, but simply waiting for my time to come, there is that wonder of, what is the point of this? Or at another point in our life, when perhaps it is our loss of work, whether the business moved on, or simply our position wasn't deemed important enough anymore, or there is an illness or an injury that comes along, we wonder at that moment, and perhaps for some time while we are enduring it, what is the point of this? How can I simply move on from this? All of these things, from the small to what loom very large in our lives, we have experienced many of those things this year, and for many people, far more people have experienced them this year. And yet we are able to still come, and there is a rejoicing in our heart for this night. Because the wonder of this night, that we are able to rejoice in the coming of the Lord, not so much that God has simply just revealed himself in a new way, but in the exact way that he does so. Because he comes to us in the difficult and the ordinary. It is precisely the way in which God wants to be with us while we are having to go through trial or hardship. And so many of the things that we usually expected to have, particularly in the celebration of fuller church, more of our family with us, and whatever other things that you all and people that you know have had to go through this year, we are still a people who rejoice in the coming of the Lord, because Christ comes in exactly every single one of those moments that you are thinking of, from the smallest to the very serious, and where we wonder, what is the purpose of all that? The trial, the tribulation, the challenge, that's exactly where God wants to be. That's exactly where God entered into the world, to show us that human face, that God simply did not just put on the show of saying, oh yes, I hear you, but no longer was God distant and far off, or only speaking in the wonderment of natural phenomenon of the awesomeness of nature, but now here, come to us small, as a child, vulnerable and completely open to the same needs and desires that each and every one of us have known. And that is how God chooses to be with us. So Christ comes to us, and he is with us. He has come to us as this little child, and he is known, and he grows in his humanness. And so God knows us, and he is shown us that he knows us so well, because he has come to be with us in that way. So we bring all of that to our God, that as many of the things that we come to have expected for this year, maybe a year ago, have been trimmed away. It leaves us with a little bit more of the bare core of why we are even here. That this happiness, this joyfulness, there is a somberness to it for many. But yet, that is precisely where God wants to be. That it is in that that God comes to us and he brings us ever closer. That God came to us not simply to join with us in those moments when we feel happy, but to be present to us. That he may be the one who inspires us to that generosity, not only to give when we see that others are in need, but also to be the willing receivers of that goodness from others and from our Lord. Sometimes when we are in a tough spot, we want to sort of fix our own things, build ourselves back up before we go out into the fray so that we can always be the one who gives. Perhaps this year, perhaps we are the one who may receive a little bit more. So we can rejoice with God. Rejoice with all the angels that God comes not just for the rich, the powerful, for the learned, but to us all. Wherever, in whatever place and time we find ourselves. So we call upon the Lord this day, and we rejoice as families, as friends, and as a people who know God who is with us. As we confess our faith in the creed this evening, where we customarily bow at the words of who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, we will kneel in honor of a special recognition of God's being born to us this night. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there, he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. As we celebrate the birth of Jesus our Lord, we rejoice in the goodness of God. So we trust, with trust, we present these needs to our Father in heaven.
That our celebration of the birth of our Savior may bring joy and transform the world through our response to God's great love, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our government leaders will continue to work for the good of all during these difficult times, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who find themselves alone and lonely, and all who are away from their loved ones today, may they be filled with the Christmas peace and joy, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That Christ, born as our Savior, may save those yet unborn, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who grieve for their departed loved ones may be consoled by the promise of and love of our Lord Jesus Christ, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
In gratitude for the many blessings that flow forth from God being with us, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the many needs of our twin parish, for all who have died, the intentions of this Mass, and those prayers we hold in the silence of our hearts. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, we praise you with joy for having sent your Son into the world. Give us grace to be faithful to the gospel we profess. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the oblation of this day's feast be pleasing to you, O Lord, we pray, that through this most holy exchange we may be found in the likeness of Christ, in whom our nature is united to you, who lives and reigns forever and ever. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in the mystery of the Word made flesh, a new light of your glory has shone upon the eyes of our mind, so that as we recognize in him God made visible, we may be caught up through him in love of things invisible. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Walker, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Lamb of God, behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Let us pray. Grant us, we pray, O Lord our God, that we who are gladdened by participation in the feast of our Redeemer's Nativity may, through an honorable way of life, become worthy of union with him who lives and reigns forever and ever. I'd like to mention that we do have a gift from the parish available for you on your way out. Each family is welcome to take a copy of one of these books by Matthew Kelly, I Heard God Laugh, and you're welcome to keep that. The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Thanks be to God.